Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and on this channel, we discuss and break down popular music video effects and techniques for creative edits. Today, we're going to be breaking down this smooth slide whip transition that you can make using After Effects and Adobe Premiere Pro. It's really great for music videos and any type of creative edit. I gotta say, it's great to be back on the channel after a week-long hiatus. I was on a cruise in the Bahamas, my first cruise ever. It was dope, spent a lot of time in the sun and hung out with my family, which was great, but I'm stoked to be back in the office and making some more videos with y'all. I also want to mention that I am totally open to collaborating with all of you guys who watch my videos, so if you want to get your music video footage featured on my channel, hit me up on Instagram at Venture Visuals. For those of you who do send me your music video footage so that I can edit it on my channel, I'll give you a 50% discount to the video editing store on venturevisuals.com, and I'll also shout you out in those videos that I use your footage and include all of your links below the video so that people can funnel in and follow you and find your work as well. So if that sounds interesting to you, definitely visit my Instagram and shoot me a message. So if you're excited to get after today, definitely hit the like button down below and let's get into the tutorial. So there's a couple different things happening in this effect. We have some layering going on. So we have this rotoscoped layer of him performing right on top, sitting on top of these other layers. Behind that is a overlay from my overlay pack. We also have this echo coming off of his rotoscope outline. And then in the background, we're just using an offset effect and keyframing it from the left to the right. And then at the end of this effect, we also have this light leak that shines behind him on the background. What we got to do first is figure out where we want the effect to start. So what I'm going to do first is just hit C, which is cut. And I'm just going to cut that area right there where the transition is going to start. And then I'm going to go to where this transition is going to end. So maybe right here as the beat starts to hit again. So we're going to cut right there. Now what we're going to do with this clip is just hold option and drag it up one layer. Now what we need to do is come all the way back to where this transition effect is going to start. We're going to click on this bottom layer right here, right click on it, and then we're going to hit add frame hold. So this is just going to make it a freeze frame. It's just an alternative to taking a screenshot of this exact frame. If I hide this top layer, which we did not add the frame hold to, we can see what this looks like. So you're going to see it stop here. Ready? Now this top layer is going to be our rotoscope layer. So what we're going to do is turn that layer back on, right click on it, hit nest, okay. And then we're going to right click on it again, replace with After Effects composition. So now that we're here in After Effects, all we need to do is click on this layer. We're going to come up here to our Rotobrush tool, click on that, double click on our frame right here. And we're just going to start tracing the artist or whatever it is that you're going to be cutting out and placing on top of the other layer. So I'm just gonna make a few quick tracings here by just clicking and dragging over the areas that I do want and holding option and clicking over the areas that I don't want. And then when I'm done tracing each frame, I can just hit 2 and that's gonna take it to the next frame and it automatically traces it for us. Now I'm at the last frame. I've got them all rotoscoped out. Now I'm just going to come back up here to my composition. You can just scroll over to see how our rotoscope is looking. So it's looking really good. If you don't see this transparent background, just toggle your transparency grid right here. From here, what we're going to do is just hit Command S, and that's going to save it back into Premiere Pro. So now we're back in Premiere Pro. So check out what we're looking like at the moment. So I'm thinking that this transition should actually end on this clap right here. So what we're going to do is just shorten it up a little bit here and drag this clip out. Now what I'm going to do is just come over here to my effects panel, type in echo, throw one of those onto our rotoscope layer, change it from add to composite in front. And then we're going to change the number of echoes to something like 5. Then we're going to hold option and drag this layer up above one. And we're going to delete the echo on that top layer. And we're going to take this bottom layer and change the opacity to screen so we kind of get more of the blending effect happening behind him. Now we're going to do this smooth slide whip transition with the background here. So what we're going to do is just come over here to our effects and we're going to type in an effect called offset. We're going to click and drag that offset onto our background clip here, the one that we have our frame hold on, and we're going to just keyframe the shift center too. So we're going to make a keyframe right here on this first frame. We're going to come over a little bit and just change the amount here on our shift center too. And that's gonna automatically create another keyframe here. So once you make one keyframe on any effect and you tweak the effect later on, it's gonna make another keyframe automatically. So you can see we've adjusted the background quite a bit. I'm gonna drag this keyframe over here to the right, all the way to the very last frame. And then on this first keyframe, I'm gonna right click on it, come to temporal interpolation and hit ease out. All I'm gonna do from here is just drop down this arrow of the shift center two. And with this keyframe selected, I can just speed ramp how fast this transition is gonna start. You can see it starts really slow and then it gets really fast towards the end. So what I'm gonna do is add some Gaussian blur to this. I'm gonna throw a Gaussian blur onto this background layer and we're gonna keyframe the blurriness of the horizontal pixels here. So I'm just gonna keyframe once in the beginning at 0 and then towards the end, it's gonna be really blurry. So I'm gonna increase the blurriness and that's gonna automatically make our keyframe right there. I'm gonna drag that towards the end. So now we have this where it starts not so blurry and it gets really blurry as it speeds up. Pretty dope. What I'm gonna do now is just drag these two rotoscoped layers up. And what I'm gonna do to make this look a little more interesting is just throw an overlay layer behind our rotoscoped layer. So I have a bunch of texture overlays in my texture overlays pack on venturevisuals.com. We're gonna take these diagonal glyphs right here so you can see how that looks just as an overlay. So what we're gonna do is just click and drag that onto the layer below our rotoscopes. So we just need to decrease the scale of this overlay a little bit. And you can play around with this. This is totally up to you. So we can see there's the edges of our overlay. And now what you can do is either change the blend mode. But what I did for this specific example was I came over here to effects, typed in key, went with a color key on this diagonal glyphs overlay. So I'm just gonna take this dropper and hit the black space behind it so you can see the key color is black. And now what I'm gonna do is just increase the color tolerance and you get this really cool look. And that gets rid of all the black space around this specific overlay. I'm also gonna use a light leak from my light leak pack, which is also on venturevisuals.com to kind of lead us into the next clip. I'm just gonna find one of these light leaks that is gonna be really quick. I think light leak 17 is actually our best bet here. So we're just gonna click and drag this light leak onto its own separate layer from the others. We're gonna drag it so that the brightest part of this light leak is happening as the transition is happening. So you can see where the cut is. So we're gonna drag that brightest spot of our light leak over that area. Now what I'm gonna do is change the opacity of this light leak from normal to screen. And you can see it now kind of blending through and we have it placed behind the rotoscope layers. So the light leak is not really affecting the artist. And then after you throw all of that together, you get something like this. If you're a creative person and joining a community of other creatives sounds like a good idea, definitely consider hitting the subscribe button down below. We're gonna be dropping a lot of new tutorials and video editing packs on venturevisuals.com. And I would love for you guys to join us on this journey. If you're looking to add some sauce to your visuals today, definitely consider checking out my website, venturevisuals.com. I have a free pack on there where you can try out every single one of my products on the website. And if you're watching any videos out there and want me to break down and explain the effects used in those videos, definitely comment down below and let me know. I'm gonna do my best to make tutorials for everybody who comments. Until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.